Hello everybody, my name is Frost, your Frost is Snowpickle, and welcome back to Portal. I apparently did not start recording this. We're doing the challenge chambers. Right thus far I got the bronze and silver medal on this first one, chamber 13. That's all you missed. I did it in 7 portals, and then I did it in 5. But apparently the gold medal is doing it in 4 portals, and I'm not sure how to achieve that. Cause I think we need 2 portals right here at the start. To somehow get unless is there any way to shoot a portal into there from on top of this button? Is there any way that that would actually be useful, though? Because you can't get the cube without getting up to here. And then from up here... What? Because I know how you do 5 portals. 5 portals, you put one up there. Take this cube, bring it over to here. Well, now we've just completely screwed it up. So we may as well just jump up into the... May as well just jump into that thing. Or just... Yeah, let's just jump into that so that we can do that. Alright.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from birth, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
I don't think I'm able to grab that from down here. I think it's placed just far enough away that I can't. I think I have to portal up to there so that I can do this. Figure this out. Can I shoot any portals into there that actually help me? Portal there, but I don't think that helps me much because I wouldn't be able to get that thing up there. And if I drop down onto here, then what? here, what would I do that would... Because I need to have both buttons pressed in order to do anything actually useful. And I can only shoot one more portal. So let me jump into that so that I can reset.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
I think I have to do these two portals at the start. I think there's no other way than to do that. This in. But I still don't see how that helps us. Because we need to get that button pressed down and get a portal into there. This can press buttons. All right, hold on. Let me try something here.
To ensure the safe performance of all authorized activities, do not destroy vital testing apparatus.
Can that press a button? No, it cannot. What the heck? All right, hit me. Okay.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
Can I jump over to that? So I don't know how that would actually help anyways. Can't grab that from the floor, right? No. I have no idea what I'm supposed to do. I hate to do this, but I might genuinely have to look up a walkthrough.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test...
I'm sorry to do this, but... I see. I don't think I would have figured that out.
Could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An incubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
Okay. Shoot. God damn it. Screwed it up.
You are in control of both portals. This next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline. You are in control of both portals. This next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
God damn it! Even knowing how to do
now
it, I can't actually do it.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
What the heck?
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
God damn it! The one time that I was actually able to get it over there is the one time that...
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline. Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
What the heck? I know what I need to do, and I can't do it.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
God damn it!
control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
It looks so easy in the
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with septic salve and adrenaline.
God damn it!
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time.
I'm sick
if
of
you become
lightheaded line, so
from
gonna...
thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
The portal there. I'm gonna take this, and then I'm gonna save game here. I actually landed it, and I fell off. Come on!
Part of a previously mentioned required test protocol, we can no longer lie to you. When the testing is over, you will be missed.
So there. Did it in four portals after watching a walkthrough and taking numerous attempts. Now we have to do least steps.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline. Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
God damn it! Does it count as a step? Okay.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive. Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline. As part of a previously mentioned required test protocol, we can no longer lie to you. When the testing is over, you will be missed.
30 is the baseline. Probably because you can use portals to travel. I see. I've been doing it very...
You are in control of both portals. This next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
What the heck? It just made me take, like, 5 steps when I didn't move anywhere. That's complete BS.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
is not going... Oop, that was stupid. This is not going according to plan.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline. As part of a previously mentioned required test protocol, we can no longer lie to you. When the testing is over, you will be missed.
Supposed to do that in under 30 steps. I don't understand. And 30 steps is the baseline. You get a minimum, you have to get at a minimum 3 steps right at the start.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
Every time you fall, it still counts as taking a step. Okay, that's... look at this. I did not touch a button there, and it bumped me up from like 9 to 20. How am I supposed to contend with BS like that?
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
Okay.
are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become
lightheaded, feel free
to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and... Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
Oh, come on. Wasn't touching anything there. And it added 9 steps all on its own. How are you supposed to complete a level in minimum steps when it has such terrible physics that make you take like 50 extra steps unprompted?
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out.
Yeah, no, I bet it'll take a very, very long time.
An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline. Part of a previously mentioned required test protocol, we
26.
Can no longer lie to you. When the testing is over, you will be missed.
20. Yeah, that's funny. Real funny game. Yeah, I'm not gonna keep doing least steps. Let's try least time.
You are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation is...
God damn it!
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from thirst, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline. As part of a previously mentioned required test protocol, we can no longer lie to you. When the testing is over, you will be missed.
19. Don't think I'm gonna be able to get that. Try this one with... Oh, that one's got moving platforms as well, and I... Oh, wait, no. Ugh. That's the one that has a whole bunch of stuff in it. Right? I'm just gonna try to get the achievement where you get rid of all of the cameras. I don't feel like doing more of those challenges right now. God damn it, I didn't mean to back all the way out. Just meant to go back to the main menu. Yeah, flick it and throw with left click. That's what I eventually ended up doing, but it really... It was entirely dependent on it deciding that it wanted to give me... Chapter 1. It was entirely dependent on it wanting to give me the right throw. It wanting to angle it right. Because... Technically, you can... If you're really, really, really good at the game, you can get things to go somewhat
Hello,
reliably.
Hello, and
but
again, welcome to the Aperture Science Computer
Aided physics
Admission
don't like
Center.
To run
we
the same
a brief
way
detention.
Every time.
The relaxation vault has been a pleasant one. Your specimen has been processed, and we are now ready to begin the test proper. Before we start, however, keep in mind that although fun and learning are the primary goals of all Enrichment Center activities, serious injuries may occur. For your own safety and the safety of others, please refrain from stand back. The portal will open in 3, 2, 1.
Can't do anything with that, so I have to do the transmission received on this level. That's one. Don't have the portal gun yet, so that I can't do much with transmission received.
Excellent. Please proceed into the chamber lock after completing each test. First, however, note
the
incandescent particle field
the
across the exit.
Camera,
this Aperture Science material emancipation
right
grid will vaporize
that.
Any unauthorized equipment that passes through it. For instance, the Aperture Science weighted storage cube. Please place the weighted storage cube on the 1500 megawatt Aperture Science heavy duty super colliding suit.
I don't actually know where the radio is that's playing. Oh, there it is.
Please place the weighted storage cube on the 1500 megawatt Aperture Science heavy duty super colliding super button.
Missed. No. Give me the thing back.
Perfect. Please move quickly to the chamber lock, as the effects of prolonged exposure to the button are not part of this test.
That's 2 of 6, or 2 of 26. Do a BSG. I don't know what a BSG is.
You're doing very well. Please be advised that a noticeable taste of blood is not part of any test protocol, but is an unintended side effect of the Aperture Science Material Emancipation Grip, which may, in semi-rare cases, emancipate dental fillings, crowns, tooth enamel, and teeth.
Fun. It's all the way up there, so...
Very good. You are now in possession of the Aperture Science handheld portal device. With it, you can create your own portals. These intradimensional gates have proven to be completely safe.
No.
The device, however, has not. Do not touch the operational end of the device. Do not look directly at the operational end of the device. Do not submerge the device in liquid, even partially. Most importantly, under no circumstances should you...
Okay. Where do you want me to go?
To ensure the safe performance of all authorized activities, do not destroy vital testing apparatus.
Are there any more cameras in here? I'm not seeing any more. So I think that's all of the cameras dealt with from that level. And it's the first three transmissions received.
Please proceed to the chamber lock. Mind the gap. For your own safety, do not destroy vital testing apparatus.
Where is it? What, do you want me to like drop it down from the sky or something? Yes, you did. Okay. So we have to be at the right Y level as well for the transmission received to work. That is going to be annoying.
Welcome to test chamber 4. You're doing quite well. Certain objects may be vital to your success. Do not destroy testing apparatus.
God damn, what the?
Once again, excellent work. As part of a required test protocol, we will not monitor the next test chamber. You will be entirely on your
26.
Own. Good luck. Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
We will not monitor it. Wait, that camera was vital.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed. Part of a required test protocol, our previous statement suggesting that we would not monitor this chamber was an outright fabrication. Good job. As part of a required test protocol, we will stop enhancing the truth in 3, Two.
I need to reload the chamber.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed.
Transmission received.
Vital testing apparatus destroyed. As part of a required test protocol, our previous statement suggesting that we would not monitor this chamber was an outright fabrication. Good job. As part of a required test protocol, we will stop enhancing the truth in 3, 2.
See, the subtitles there are actually not helpful because they cut out the fact that what GLaDOS is saying cuts out. So you just lose the entire
While safety
show.
Is one of many Enrichment Center goals, the Aperture Science High Energy Pellet seen to the left of the chamber can and has caused permanent disabilities such as vaporization. Please, unbelievable. You.
Subject name here.
Must be the pride of.
Subject hometown here.
Did I get all the cameras? I don't think I got any cameras in this chamber. Are there any cameras? There aren't any cameras in this chamber.
Warning devices are required on all mobile equipment. However, alarms and flashing hazard lights have been found to agitate the high energy pellet and have therefore been disabled for your safety. Now use the Aperture Science unstationary scaffold to reach the chamber lock.
No cameras in here either. She must have realized that, putting the cameras was not working out.
Please note that we have added a consequence for failure. Any contact with the chamber floor will result in an unsatisfactory mark on your official testing record, followed by death. Good luck.
I hear the... There it is. They're getting really tricky with these hiding spots.
Very impressive. Please note that any appearance of danger is merely a device to enhance your testing experience.
I'm guessing it's going to be like all the way back to the beginning. Yeah. There it is. They're getting really tricky with these things. With these transmission received things.
The Enrichment Center regrets to inform you that this next test is impossible. Make no attempt to solve it. The Enrichment Center apologizes for this clearly broken test chamber. Once again, the Enrichment Center offers its most sincere apologies on the occasion of this unsolvable test environment.
Yeah, so you've said, but I know that the test is so cool.
Frankly, this chamber was a mistake. If we were you, we would quit now.
There it is.
No one will blame you for giving up. In fact, quitting at this point is a perfectly reasonable response.
For God's sakes.
Fantastic. You remain resolute and resourceful in an atmosphere of extreme pessimism.
Just want to double check and make sure there aren't any cameras in here. Because I haven't seen any cameras for a while. I don't remember that happening. Was it always set up so that that elevator came down as you reached the end of that level? Or is that a new feature?
Hello again. To reiterate, previous momentum.
Alright, I got rid of the camera there.
Spectacular. You appear to understand how a portal affects forward momentum, or to be more precise, how it does not.
Where is it? There it is. Right there. Got it! Wow, that was a good grab. Got it.
Momentum, a function of mass and velocity, is conserved between portals. In layman's terms, speedy thing goes in, speedy thing comes out.
We're doing so much better at this than we were at the challenge chambers.
The Enrichment Center promises to always provide a safe testing environment. In dangerous testing environments, the Enrichment Center promises to always provide useful advice. For instance, the floor here will kill you. Try to avoid it. Modified so that it can now manufacture two linked portals at once. As part of an optional test protocol, we are pleased to present an amusing fact. The device is now more valuable than the organs and combined incomes of everyone in.
Subject home house, here.
not sure how to get that. Let's try this first. That worked. Now we're kind of stuck here. And it's causing visual glitches. Just right at the center here. Nice. Alright, well, with that out of the way. Any cameras? Nope. Okay. Off we go. Where is it? They didn't, like, put it on the back of one of those things, did they? Well, they absolutely did. I don't see it anywhere. I'm almost positive it's on the back of that thing. Listen to how loud it is over here. Unless it's up there somewhere. God damn it. There it is. It was on the back of one of those things. Got it. What the heck? There we go. Well, I think that's where we'll end this video. Yeah. We're 1 hour and 9 minutes in, and I have class in about 2 hours. So, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed, which you probably did since you made it all the way to the end, hit every button you can find on YouTube. And I won't see you in the next one, but you'll see me in the next one if you choose to watch it. I'm just looking at a webcam, though, so yeah. Bye.